Hello students, we are going to do profit and non-profit organization and mission and vision, shared value and beliefs in our paper organization behavior with paper code BBAP 3305. I am Ragini Dixit, working as assistant professor in School of Management, BBD University. Now, contents of this presentation are: We will do types of organization, then on the basis of these categories we will do profit and non-profit organizations in detail, then concept of mission and vision for an organization, shared values and beliefs, and then conclusion. Now, coming to our first point, that is categories or types of organizations. Organizations can be categorized by on the basis of ownership, that is private and public sector. In our previous slides we have done this categorization in detail, that is private and public sector organizations. Then on the basis of motive, organization can be categorized as profit seeking or non-profit seeking organization. They are also known as not for profit organization. Then on the basis of legal structure, organizations can be categorized as sole traders, partnership, limited companies and cooperatives. Now, first we will do profit seeking organizations in detail. Profit seeking organizations operate to maximize returns for owners or shareholders, means maximize profit. Therefore, profitability is their primary objective. Such organizations can be split into two main groups, which are distinguished by the extent of liabilities the owner have for company's debts. Now, these can be unincorporated and incorporated organizations. First is unincorporated organizations. The business owners and the business itself hold the same legal identity. This means the owners are held personally responsible for the debts a company may incur because they have the same legal identity. Therefore, they are considered to have unlimited liability for the business debts. The two main types of ownership in this category are sole trader and partnership. Now, in sole trader, one sole owner of the business, that is, he is wholly liable for all the debts of the business. He is the sole trader of that business. Then partnership, if that business is in partnership, a collection of owners working together are liable for the debt as well as for the profits. Now, second type of profit making organization is incorporated. The business owners and the business itself have a separate legal identity. This means the owners are not held personally responsible for the debts a company may incur. Therefore, they are considered to have limited liability for the business debts. Now, there are also two types. The two main types of ownership in this category are private limited companies and public limited companies. Now, private limited companies, shares cannot be issued to the public. Often, a smaller company such as market town retailer, however, can be larger companies looking to retain a high degree of control. Now, public limited companies, shares can be issued to the public, and usually larger companies wish to increase funding for business ventures through the public share offering are known as public limited companies. Now, coming to not-for-profit organization. Not-for-profit organization, as the name indicates, do not set out to make a profit for their owners. This does not mean that they are unprofitable, but their aim is to provide a service to their members and subscribers rather than maximize returns for owners. Like profit-seeking companies, they aim to operate efficiently and to be cost-effective. Not-for-profit organizations include trade unions, charities, cooperatives, mutual organizations, clubs, societies, and educational establishments. Now, not-for-profit organizations exist in both the public and private sector. Public sector non-profit organizations are owned by the state and are responsible to the government for their business activities. Public sector organization can be in the form of a state-owned industry or a government-run department. Now, private sector non for profit organizations have similar structure to profit seeking companies in that they are owned by investors and responsible to the shareholders owners. However, their goal and objective do not surround profit maximization, rather focus on other goals such as ethical standards and service delivery. Now coming to our next topic, that is mission and vision of an organization. An organization's mission can be defined as its reason for existence, that is what its core purpose is. Why does an organization exist? Here are some examples of mission, that is Harley Davidson have the mission to fulfill dreams through the experience of motorcycling by providing to motorcyclists and to the general public an expanding line of motorcycles and branded products and services in selected market segments. Microsoft has a mission to empower every person and every organization on the planet to achieve more. GSK has a mission to help people do more, feel better and live longer. Well-constructed mission statement should contain the following: a brief description of what the company does and why it exists, which segment of the market it aims to supply, that is for example, company has a mission to supply luxury goods, values, ethics and culture. Then mission statement communicates this important information to its various stakeholders. Now, the importance of mission for corporate strategy, that is why mission is important for any organization. There are several reasons why a business should give serious consideration to establishing a clear concept of its corporate missions. First, values are acknowledged as integral element of consumers' buying decision. This is shown by the attention paid to them in advertising, brand building and market research. Customers ask not only what do you sell but what do you stand for, and in this case they have to describe this through their mission. Studies into organizational behavior show that people are motivated by many things. Other than money, employees are likely to be both more productive and more satisfied with their work when they feel that they are doing has whatever they are doing has significance beyond the mere pursuit of a living. They are doing something for a mission. Then some writer believes there is empirical relation between strong corporate values, and that is mission, and profitability. Now, first let us discuss what do you mean by mission statement. A mission statement is a published statement apparently of the companies or a business, that is entity's fundamental objective. That is, it is a published statement of company's fundamental objectives. In essence, a mission statement describes an organization's basic purpose and what it is trying to achieve. There is no standard format, but the four elements in the Ashrich model of mission offers a good basis for writing a mission statement. There is one model known as Ashrich model, which defines how a mission statement can be written. And according to this model, there are four elements of a mission statement. Mission statements are likely to have some of the following characteristics, that is some of the following elements according to Ashrich model. That is, first, stating the purpose of the organization, stating the business areas in which the organization intends to operate, providing a general statement of the organization's culture, and acting as a guide to develop the directions of the entity, strategy and its goal and objective. That is purpose, business areas, organization culture and its goals, strategy, entity's strategy for goals and objectives. These, that is purpose, strategy, standards, goals and behaviors, and company's values. The authors of the Ashrich models also make another point. Mission statement contain only statement of purpose and strategy, but in order for an organization to develop a sense of mission, that mission must be exhibited in the performance standards and value of the organization. That is, the sense of mission should be exhibited through the performance standards or the performance done by the employees and value of the organization. So according to Estrus mission model, a mission should have purpose, that is why the company exists, strategy, the commercial rationale, the game plan, the company values, what senior management believes in, what are their values, their goals, their objectives, and standards and behaviors, the policies and behavior patterns that guide how that organization is going to operate. So all these components make a mission for a particular organization. Now, how this mission helps in planning? The mission statement can play an important role in the strategic planning process for an organization, and it can be done through inspiring and informing. It inspires and informs planning. It does in screening, that is, plan should further the organization goals and be consistent with its value. In this way, the mission statement provides a focus for consistent strategic planning decisions, as well as this mission statement help in screening. Screening. Mission act as a yardstick by which plans are judged. Mission also affect the implementation of a plan strategy in terms of the way in which an organization carries out its business and through the culture of the organization. A mission statement can help to develop a corporate culture in an organization by communicating the organization's core values. A mission statement can also often help to establish an ethics framework within an organization. Now, coming to our next point, that is vision. What is vision? A vision is a clear, comprehensive snapshot of an organization at some point in the future, where the organization wants to be in after 5 years or 4 years, that is at some point in the future. It defines the company's direction and entails what the organization need to be like to be successful in future. It is of strategic importance to an organization to create a clear and effective vision. A clear vision helps to define the values of the organization and guides the conduct of all employees. A strong vision also leads to improved productivity and efficiency. Now let us learn what is a vision statement. A vision statement is a future-oriented declaration of the organization's purpose and aspirations, lays out the organization's purpose for being there. A clear vision helps in aligning everyone towards the same state of objective, providing a basis for goal congruence. Now, for example, the vision statement of PepsiCo is as follows. At PepsiCo, we are committed to achieving business and financial success while leaving a positive imprint on a society, that is delivering what we call performance with purpose. So vision is a future oriented declaration of what organization purpose and aspiration, and what is it lays down the organization's purpose for being there. It is a clear vision which helps in aligning everyone towards the same state of objective, that is organization objective, as well as the employees working in that organization have the same objective. They should work towards achieving a same goal. Now, role played by mission and vision. Organization's mission and vision are critical elements of a company's organizational strategy and serve as the foundation for the establishment of company's objective. Mission and vision statement play critical roles, such as they provide unanimity of purpose to organizations and spell out the context in which the organization operates. They communicate the purpose of the organization to stakeholders. They specify the direction in which the organization must move to realize the goals in the vision and mission statement. They provide the employees with a sense of belonging and identity. So they provide the purpose of an organization to a stakeholder. They realize the goals in the mission and vision statement. They specify the direction in which the organization must move, and they provide the employees with sense of belonging and identity. Now, what is the from this diagram we can conclude the relation between mission, vision and goals of an organization. First, we will establish a mission, then vision and then strategy and goals. Mission says what the company represents and values. Vision says what the company wishes to become, and strategy and goal, how the company strives to achieve its vision and measures its success. Now, coming to shared values and beliefs, concepts of shared value and beliefs. First of all, let us learn what are these shared values. Shared values and beliefs represent an important component of most private and public organizations. Shared values are organizational values that are usually developed by the organization's leadership and then adopted by the other members of the organizations. Now, these shared values and beliefs generally represent the culture of any organization. The values are shared and followed by all members of the organization when acting on behalf of the organization. So, these shared values are generally developed by the leaders and they are followed by the other members of the organization. They may also be referred to as core values. These shared values are also known as core values. Now, shared values help to define what an organization is, what an organization does, and what an organization aspires to be. What is and what an organization does and what it aspires or to be. It is common for shared values to be reduced to writing in a mission statement. Generally, these values are in writing form in a mission statement. Shared values provide overall guidance for organizational members to make the correct decisions in a given situation. They help the organizational members to make correct decisions in a particular situation. An organization driven by numbers or profits without any guiding values or vision may become dysfunctional, leading to ethical, moral, or even legal violations. So, and every organization should have core values. Implementing shared values can help an organization to avoid this problem, and leaders might impose general values over all organizational behavior, objectives, and goals. Ideally, shared values should be implemented to serve the needs of all organizational stakeholders, including employees, managers, and clients of the organizations. Now, what are the characteristics of these shared values? Every company, big or small, has its core values, which forms the basis over which the members of a company make decisions, plan strategies, and interact with each other and their stakeholders. Core values reflect the core behaviors or guiding principles that guide the actions of employees as they execute plans to achieve the mission and vision. So, these core values help the members of a company to make decisions, plan strategies, interact with each other and the other stakeholders. Stakeholders, those individuals who have interest in a company. Now, core values reflect what is important to the organization and its member. Core values are intrinsic. They come from leaders inside of the company. Core values are not necessarily dependent on the type of company or industry and may vary widely even among organizations that do similar type of work. So, core values reflect what is important to the organization. They are intrinsic, that they are formed by within the organization. Core values are not necessarily dependent on the type of company. Now, for many companies, adherence to their core values is a goal, not a reality. It is often said that companies that abandon their core values may not perform as well as those that adhere to them. Now, what are the benefits of value to an organization? Provide good basis to management for better business decisions. Improves provided services to partners, customers, real needs. Facilitate innovation to support organization competitiveness. Strong awareness of value culture with good understanding of business goals. It enhances communication and the efficiency of teamwork. And it provides commitment from partners, customers, and various other stakeholders. Now, what are the factors which are going to affect an organizational values? That is public apathy. Apathy solving community matters has held us back from progress which is otherwise within our reach. We see serious problems around us but do not try to solve them. We behave as if the problems do not exist or they are somebody else's problem. We are feared to show our apathy. Now, accountability. Indian managers are less accountable as compared to managers of the West. In West, managers are held accountable for whatever they do, but in India, they are less accountable even if they are in good position. Now, this factor is also going to affect any organization's value. Then, less professional dealing. If we compare the managers of East and West, Western managers are extremely professionals in their dealing, while Indian managers are less professionals. They work in narrow perspective, personal perspective. This lack of professionalism is even to our sense of punctuality. So, public apathy is not there, accountability is not there, less professional dealings. These all affect organizational values in any Indian organization. Now, beliefs. Now let us learn what is belief. Now, an organization's core beliefs act as a superset of criteria governing decision making, large and small, on a daily basis. Core beliefs define and create culture and act as touchstones to guide behavior. What is our belief? What we are going to believe in? What we believe? Amazon, for example, has more than a dozen leadership principles, or you can say beliefs among them. For example, it believes in customer obsession, it believes in inventing and simplifying, it believes in frugality. Now, customer obsessions, leaders start with the customer and work backward. They work vigorously to earn and keep customer trust. Although leaders pay attention to competitors, they obsess over customers. So, customer is the king. They believe in keeping the customer at the first point. Then they believe in inventing and simplifying and frugality. We try not to spend money on things that don't matter to customers. Frugality breeds resourcefulness, self-sufficiency and invention. Now, these are the beliefs on which the Amazon company works. Now, what are the causes and effects related to beliefs? The shared organizational beliefs that impact performance can take many form. Over the years, we have covered some that are particularly powerful in shaping behavior. Here are a few examples. First belief can be we can do anything we put our minds to. This belief generated a willingness to experiment and move into new markets, sometimes with unrealistic goal and plan. Your belief can be we are too big to fail. This shared organizational belief bred arrogance and lack of customer empathy. Sheer willpower and brute force will allow us to push things through. Although this leads to strong execution, it also produces bullying behavior, both internally and externally. People either have what it takes or they don't. Created an up or out culture with little development or coaching. More is always better. This belief brought about continuous stress as well as poor prioritization and higher burnout. So these are some of the beliefs which are adopted by some companies, and they believe in and what are the beliefs and what are their effect on the various organizations who are working on these beliefs. Now, our beliefs grow from what we see, hear, experience, read and think about. From these things, we develop an opinion that we hold to be true and unmovable at that time. From our beliefs, we derive our values, which can either be correct or incorrect when compared with evidence, but nonetheless hold true for us. Everyone has an internalized system of beliefs that they have developed throughout their life. So every person has his own belief. These may stem from religion or may develop separately to religions. Beliefs are concepts that we hold to be true. These are what are beliefs? These are our own concepts and we think that they are true. These may come from religion, but not always. Beliefs determine our attitudes and opinion. These beliefs help us in determining our attitudes and opinions. Now, anyone or any entity that is affected by the organization who has an interest in it is known as its stakeholder. Now, an organization should provide value to its stakeholder through its mission, vision, its beliefs and core values. How? It can control and coordinate resources to achieve goals and outcome. It can efficiently produce goods and services. It can facilitate innovation. Nothing stands still in a competitive environment, and continual improvement is essential. So any organization can take help of its mission, vision, beliefs and values to facilitate innovation, efficiently produce goals and services, and control and coordination. So we have done mission, vision and core values and beliefs. Mission, vision, profit, non-profit organizations. First, we have types of organization. We have done profit and non-profit organization. Then concept of mission, vision for an organization. Then shared values and beliefs and conclusion. This was all about your profit and non-profit organizations, mission and beliefs, shared values and beliefs. Thank you, students.